So next one more topic is remained in our thermodynamics. Okay, those are nothing but two instruments. Already I draw here. One should be bomb calorimeter, second one here the calorimeter. So both are used for the purpose of the calculation of the delta U. Calculation of which one here? The delta U is nothing but the internal energy. So first of all, I want to explain one instrument. Which one here? The bomb calorimeter. So bomb calorimeter is nothing but here one of the vessel taken. It should be made up with the steel. Which one here? It should be made up with the steel. So total in this one is the present is the water. In this one present, which one here? The water. And again I am taking here the one of the smallest container. Okay, in this container our sample compound should be taken. Which one taker in this one? Our sample compound. Okay, it is our sample compound. That our sample compound reacts with which one here? The oxygen. Reacts with which one here? Oxygen. Okay, that oxygen should be enters from this way. Oxygen should be enters from this way. Okay, in that situation our sample totally burns. Okay, whenever burning is started, the vessel also here the heated. So that heated temperature should be measured by one should be instrument. What it is here? The thermometer. What it is here? The thermometer. Especially bomb calorimeter is used for the heat energy at constant volume. At which one here? The constant volume. At constant volume for the calculation of the absorbing heat energy. Okay, is only done by the bomb calorimeter. In the bomb calorimeter, we are using the one of the tight container. In the tight container, we are taking the sample. That sample totally burns in the presence of oxygen. And after that one, the total result should be here the heated. That heated should be measured by here the thermometer. So, on using the thermometer temperature, we can substitute the values. Q is equal to C into M into delta T. Okay, so what is the equation for this one? Q is equal to C into M into delta T. So from this one we can also write CV delta T. We know that one. CV is nothing but the heat capacity at constant value. So that's why I'm using here the at constant value. So individually C is nothing but the specific heat. So M is nothing but the mass of substance which is taken as a sample in the bomb calorimeter, and delta T is nothing but temperature before the participation, okay, of the reaction. The temperature is a T1. After the reaction there should be the T2. So what will be T is here? T2 minus T1. It should be calculated by here the delta T. Okay, calculated by which one here? Delta T. So those values are substituted in this one. We have to calculate which one here? The delta U. Why? Because already we know that one. CV delta T is nothing but the delta T, delta U. From this equation, from the bomb calorimeter, we can use this one. Okay, one more instrument. What it is here? The calorimeter. What it is here? The calorimeter. So in the calorimeter, this instrument is used at the conditions are constant pressure. Which one here? The constant pressure. For the constant pressure calculation of the heat energy, we can use one of the instrument. What it is here? The calorimeter. Okay, so in this one we are taking one of the component, one of the vessel. In this vessel reaction mixture is there. Okay, whenever the reaction mixture undergoes the reaction, there should be the heat evolves. That heat is calculated by which one? Thermometer. Okay, depending upon this one also we have to calculate the delta H. We have to calculate delta H. Here the delta U, here the delta H. Okay, delta H is nothing but the enthalpy change. Enthalpy change either positive or the negative. So whenever the positive means heat is absorbed. Whenever the negative is, heat is here the evolved. It is the calorimeter, it is the bomb calorimeter, which are belongs to calculation of the delta U and calculation of the delta H practically or experimentally. Okay, it is the information about the bomb calorimeter, calorimeter. Next, in our thermodynamics, we just considered about the thermodynamics third law. What it is here? The thermodynamics third law. Already we are completed thermodynamics first law, second law. Next, we are entering into which one here? The thermodynamics third law. So before that one, I want to repeat or revise. Thermodynamics first law tells about the mathematical equation. What it is here? The delta U is equal to Q plus W. Okay, that means internal change in internal energy affected by the heat energy and as well as here the work. Okay, that should be thermodynamics first law. Next of all, thermodynamics second law. Thermodynamics second law tells about here the all the spontaneous reactions are here the irreversible and entropy of those reactions are always here the increases. Next, last topic, what it is here the thermodynamics third law. Okay, it is our last one. Thermodynamics third law tells about here simple definition. It tells about the entropy. Which one here? Entropy. The entropy of pure crystalline solid is zero. Is which one here? The zero at absolute temperature. At which temperature here? Absolute temperature. So that is called as here the thermodynamics third law. So what it tells here, the thermodynamics third law is nothing but the entropy of the pure crystalline solid is always zero at absolute temperature. So absolute temperature is nothing but we can take what it is here, the -273 degree centigrade Kelvin. So that should be called as here the absolute temperature. Okay, it is our thermodynamics. So based upon the thermodynamics, all the natural reactions and all which are necessary in our regular life, we can also conclude that one. It is our thermodynamics.